Chapter 1, The Heredity and Evolution, includes the second most important topic, which is the evolution. Now let us see what is evolution. Evolution is nothing but a gradual change occurring in living organism over a long duration. This is a very slow going process through which development of organism is achieved. Evolution is a gradual change, a very slow change which keeps on occurring for a very long duration. We all know that 3.5 billion years ago, there were no human beings which were on the earth. But later on, after years, we saw that living organisms started existing on the earth. And now at present, there are crores of species of plants and animals which are present. So we'll be studying about the theory of evolution. This theory of evolution says that the living material was first occurred in the ocean, and they were unicellular organism. This unicellular organism, after some years, what happened was changes occurred, which lead to large organism, and multicellular organism. These changes which occurred were approximately 300 crore years. Okay, after this 300 crore years, we saw this organism, unicellular organism, converting into large organism and multicellular organism. Okay, so this overall change, or you can say this multidimensional change which occurred, is known as evolution. So this was what actually happened. This ocean was the first place where the living organism was identified, and this living organism were not huge or multicellular, they were unicellular organism and small, very small. You all know that unicellular are very, very tiny. This unicellular organism, after 300 crore years, what happened was they changed into large organism and multicellular organism. This overall change which occurred from unicellular to multicellular, from small organism to large organism and beyond that, is known as the evolution. Now let us see the evidence of evolution. Evidence of evolution. There are basically six evidence which we have found. The first one is the morphological evidence. Second one, anatomical evidence. Third one, vestigial evidence. Fourth one is paleontological evidence. The fifth one, connecting links. And the last one is embryological evidence. Morphological evidence. Just by looking at the animals or the plants, we can say that they have certain similarities. For example, the structure of the mouth, the position of the eyes, then structure of nostrils, then the thickened hair in the body of the animals can tell some similarity, some relation. We even see in plants, they have same leaf shape, then leaf venation, then the petiole, etc. also show some similarities, and it shows that they might have having some common ancestors. So this was all about morphological evidence. Then the anatomical evidence. Anatomical is nothing but the internal similarities. We have seen that if we see the human hand, the cat's foreleg, then patagium of bat, then flippers of whale, All these four have same bone structures. If we see it carefully in this picture, you can see they have almost the same joining and the bone structure, but the use of these organs is different in these animals. So again, the similarities of the bones and the joining in them also again shows the similarity in the ancestors. They might have having some similar ancestors, and then they got diverted into different organisms. So this was all about the anatomical evidence. The third one is the vestigial evidence. Vestigial itself says the useless organs or undeveloped organs or degraded organs. These organs are not at all used a lot, but at certain point it is useful. Take for example the appendix in human being. It is still not known that what is the use of this appendix. Now where is this appendix located? If you see the small intestine and large intestine, at the end you will see a small organ which is present at the end tip. This is nothing but the appendix of the human being. As I've told you that it is useless in human being, but this same appendix is useful in the ruminants. What are ruminants? Ruminants are those animals which are having four chambers in their stomach. They can ferment the food and then they can reuse it. Now what is examples of ruminant which I can give you is the cow, the camels, etc. So this was all about the vestigial organs. Next one is the paleontological evidence. Paleontological itself says the olden evidence. We all know that the various animals and organisms which were millions of years before living, after years and when they die, they get buried inside the soil. It can be plants, it can be animals. We know that there were dinosaurs existing. How do we came to know about the dinosaurs? It is because that the living organism which are buried inside the soil, later on when we dig it, we find them in the form of fossils. Now these fossils are again very important to study about the evolution of the organism. So this was again a evidence which was found and which is useful to study about the evolution in living beings. The next one is the connecting links. Now we have also seen some plants and animals who show some morphological characteristics by which they can be related to two different groups. Here what happens is we have seen organisms which show some relation with other organisms, which then again show some connecting link between the two organisms, which are very much different but have some similarities in them and are present from different group but still have some similarities. So this kind of evidence is called as connecting link. Suppose take an example of parapetous characters like segmented body, as you can see here, the thin cuticle and peripedia like organs are present. Similarly, these animals show open circulatory system similar to arthropodas. This indicates that peripatus is connected, is having some connected link between annelida and arthropoda. So this single organism is connecting with these two different classes. So this shows the connective link between them. Then the last one is the embryological evidence. Now if we see this picture, in this picture we see embryos during different stages. If we compare the initial embryo stage of every vertebrates, it is having maximum similarities. But later on, as the duration increases, as the stages increases, the similarities decreases. And this decrease in the similarity shows in difference in organism. But the earlier similarities which we see in the embryonic structure of various organisms shows that they must be having some common ancestors. So this was all about the evidence of evolution. In the upcoming video, we'll be studying about Darwin's theory of natural selection.